Now, I would like to also take you quickly through part 5 of recent changes made to CETA, effective on 1st of February 2020. Let's look at basis of assessment. Section 29 has been amended. In this case, the basis for assessment of new company and cessation of companies have been amended to eliminate effect of double taxation. At commencement, first year shall be profit from the commencement to the last day of the company's accounting year end. Second year shall be profit from the end of its first year to the accounting year end. Third year shall be profit from the end of the second accounting year end to the last day of the accounting year. The basis for assessment is now on preceding year basis, the same that hitherto applies to an ongoing business profit assessment to taxes. At cessation, the profit accessible to tax is the profit recorded from the beginning of the year to the last day when the business ceased. Let me quickly explain this, what it means, this base of assessment. There are three bases of assessment when we want to compute for company income taxes. We have one basis we call commencement basis. That is applied when a business is relatively new and is making returns for the first time. Then we have change in accounting date, when the company changed its accounting year. And the third one is cessation. Before now, when you do commencement to complete your taxes, definitely you pay double taxes. Because three compositions are required, there's overlapping. And we've been complaining about this for too long. And when you are ceasing business as well, then you also pay double taxes. When you do change in accounting date, you always also pay double taxes. But the two that have been addressed right now with these recent changes is commencement and cessation. So they are now on preceding year basis. That is, the activity for last year are subject to tax this year. So with that, the problem of double taxation has been eliminated. When you're a new company that you are just filing for the first time, or maybe you're an old company that you want to, you know, stop operation permanently. So that's a good news right there. And I believe it's a way to encourage new startup.